So, this is going to be the only episode, and I'm probably going to take a break tomorrow, so no episode then. This is going to be a 45-minute in-and-out missing. The reason? Well, this is going to get boring. It's going to get boring very fast. Why am I taking damage? So what, this just makes me constantly take damage? The benefit being whenever I hit something, I restore a ton. Okay, that's fair. We have a mission. Ah, yes, we have to fight the Star Scouter. I almost forgot about that. I was gonna go and start building down in hell, but we have other business, eh? This is not gonna go well. Oh, yeah, and the fact that literally everything here is now missing is great. Heckin' wonderful. Yeah, I still don't know why my map is missing. Well, I do, it's because of the whole Calamity mishap. I can use this arena, yeah. Alright. Let's see. That's that. That's that. I still have this buff, so may as well use it. Well, this doesn't work, I need to be up here. Is it during the day only, or what the heck's going on here? Because I am not fighting him in space, he's a butthead in space. Oh! This is not the boss I thought it was. Boop, 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 dies. Did he one-shot me to anyone else? Cause it looks like he one-shot me. Well, that was interesting, wouldn't you say? Never had that happen before. Not in my life. The fight was going really well, but I never healed. Single hit point, I think. Unless I healed a whole bunch, that's how I somehow managed to tank that one hit. But yeah, him one-shotting me the first time, kind of ruined the mood. By a lot. And somehow, without the godly power, I was stronger than with it. Okay. Put all the junk in the box. There. That's not a lot of junk. Why is my inventory still full? Not using those. This is barely activating for some reason, and only half the time. I can afford that. Not using that. Never using that again. This makes sense. Why the bed is here, I have no clue. But yeah, this fight has nothing to do with vertical momentum. You do not go up. Ever. Except when you have to jump that one time, and that's why I'll be keeping those. Except this armor already gives me a double jump. Alright, brain is doing things. Please hold while brain does things. I was not expecting him to have a second phase like that, I will say. Oh, so after the Frostbark boots wear out, then is when the other jump comes in. That is just weird. Probably do this fight from the coziness of a minecart, to be honest. It's literally left right movement. Now then, let's try this again. Okay, that's not going to work ever again. That's nice to know. Yeah, no, I took 245 damage from falling. Okay, so one campfire is enough that I'm able to, you know, heal. I don't like using potions like that, because as you can see, I just bought all the potions, and that fight went from super difficult but fair. Let me just see the thing. It took less than a minute. Less than a minute. And I took 16 hits in that time. And I got down to 100 health. But it took less than a minute to kill a boss. Does that seem about right? You know, boss that's supposed to be super duper difficult, that I've died to multiple times, and it's been a tough fight to the end. I beat it in under a minute. Does that seem right? I don't think that's right. But I'm gonna do it because it works. When it says hit scanner, it literally means that it will have no travel time, in quotes. That's a pretty good gun. No pierce on it, though. Anyways, I'm gonna have this for the rest of the game. Because it goes in the pet slot, and it does damage. Who wouldn't use it? Yay, I can now heal all the nobody. did you survive? That potion has been drunkified twice. Should not still be here, but it is. Thank you for your service. So, now! Wait, I got rage. Nice. Yes. Give that back. So, stack that, loot all. This stays with me. Dungeon, dungeon, dungeon. There. I'm gonna go put the bed back down there so I respawn there. Potions two. Do 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 do. Huh, nobody's got an exclamation point above their head like, hey, you can buy this from me. And we do have empty houses. House. Yeah, I remember that boss being a gigantic, annoying worm who was very, very, very hard to kill. But I'm glad it's just, you know, Marsons. Handgun can be made into some powerful garbage. It's a very fast firing frickin'. Of course. Phoenix. Yes. No paths found in for this recipe. Interesting. Cursed capper, which is then used to make this, which is then used to make Dodo's hand cannon, or the prideful hunter's planar ripper, with luminite. All that from a gosh dang hand cannon. Got some splaining to do. Where's my weapons? There's my weapons. Into the weapons. Alright, now. I'm sad to leave all of these buffs behind, but it's what I gotta do. Yeah, I can take one voodoo doll. Hail. Oh, I haven't kept any. Good. Hi, nurse. So, let me show you how I'm going to bridge across hell. I also should have brought some dynamite, but... there's the man of the hour. not the wall of flesh. No. I still have 2 platinum on me? Wait. This is not in the rule book. I was supposed to die there, lose nothing. God. Ew. And then now that Boss Zen is active, start bridging across hell. Instead, I've just lost 2 platinum for literally no reason. Ow. Ow. So instead of losing nothing, I've now lost most of my money. All of my money. Why is it whenever I get money, I immediately lose it? Oh yeah, because I'm a dummy. Anyways. You gonna pull me back? How did I just take 831 damage from falling 2 feet? And that dealt 4. Yeah, I like this item. This item's fun. So, the plan is no enemies are going to spawn. Because Boss Zen from Calamity, thank you. It's not a vanilla effect. So now no enemies are going to spawn. I have free reign over all of hell. Except to the right side. Not even the Blood Moon will spawn enemies. So, this is what I'm going to be doing for the next, like, 5 hours. Clearing out hell, making sure there's a path. But I'm not going to make 5 videos on it, because that's the one way to lose all of your non-existent subscribers. I'm also going to use dynamite to speed this up. Or I would, if I had money! So, what am I going to do over the fact that I have no money? Well, I'm going to get the Fist Finder and unlock tons of money. Yep, still have 3 of these. So the more mana I have, the more the specter healing works. Interesting. Honestly, expecting it to be a bit easier to kill with this, but they helped a lot. So that's money. And that's a sextant. That's how it's supposed to go. Now we just keep doing that until we have tons and tons of money. Also gives the money. Nice. Oh, nice. I finally got the arrow stone. It doesn't say that it drops a frickin' stone like it should. It's not saying this is dropped by the Desert Scourge. That's definitely Plantera. That's definitely Cryogen. That's probably Calamitous? Don't know though. Anyways. Where is the Ceph? There. Stress pills we might want. Deep diver is good. Yeah, that's a good replacement for the scarf well in the depths. Now you're just giving me all of them, okay. Well, wasn't that exciting, fighting the Desert Scourge 17 times. I was on the edge of my seat the entire time. And out of that, we got... that's the Heart of Darkness I usually use, I'm pretty sure. And one set of stress spells. For 17 treasure bags. And I believe I only need one Heart of the Elements, so yeah, these others can go. Oh yeah, and I got one Deep Diver, and I got zero copies of the, Bouncy version. The throwing weapon that bounces. The one that I used for a long time. We got a pretty even spread of coral and all that. Another one? Oh yeah, and he's still down there. So still no clue what to do with the mystery meteorites. And I have three of them now. Brave. This is only used to make the Supreme Bait Tackle Box, and that's used for nothing else. So, that tells me to just dump all of this in here. This is why, for only like 5 reversity tokens, this is insane. Now, I can make the fist finder. We need the pocket guide, the sextant, and the wither radio. We got a cell phone. Where's Guidey? There. One sec. Interesting. As much as I'd like to get one of those, I don't think we can. Until a traveling merchant turns up with the Pip-Boy 3K. Anyways, I'm going to call it for that this episode. As soon as I make sure that there's no more junk. Does this just turn anything it catches golden? I don't know. No. Just looks cool. I can live with that. Safe is in the piggy bank. Of course it is. I would have 4 platinum if I hadn't yeeted myself into the abyss. But I'm down with what I got. Cheapskate. Guess no refunds is right. Alright, well, I'm going to end the episode there. Thanks for sitting through the cellathon. And if you guys enjoyed this video, I hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace.